Yo, what's up, guys? So I wanted to talk a little bit about how you really actually can't fake the subtle cues of non-neediness. They show up actually after you're getting laid, paid, whatever the case may be. You know, in the case of business, I bring this up because, you know, if you haven't had a sale in a while in your business, or you're, you know, more relatable with most of you, if you're out of work or you're concerned about your flow of income and you go out on a job interview, you're going to be very nervous. You know, there's going to be things about you that come across as like, you really need this. And you just can't, there's almost nothing you could do to really fake the fact that you're secure with your level of income and you don't actually need the sale. In the same way, you can't really fake the fact that you're getting laid and you have abundance and you don't need the girl that you're talking to. That is something that there's just subtle little things that happen, subtle little communications that actually occur within your body. Once you start getting results, that women pick up on this and they're like, oh shit. And also you could see it too in other guys. You could see guys who are needy and they have like this subtle little thing where they're just like looking and reaching and trying to see, you know, what all the girls are doing, what they think about them and stuff. But the upside of this, there's downside and upside. Downside is that while you're not getting laid, it's gonna be really hard for you to break through this little plateau of feeling like you need to grasp onto something with the girl. You need to make it work. This is a big deal. Which consequent, it's interesting. It's like it pushes them away. It's like you're grabbing at it subtly in little ways you can't even probably tell. And it's like, it's so annoying too, because you're trying to just get it done, right? You're going out for a purpose, right? You're there to close. Well, it's like you're there to close, but when you are already getting laid, it's like you are a lot more relaxed. You know what it's like to have been with a girl as hot as the girl that you're talking to. You have several of them. You can sort of, it's just subtle little things that show up in your personality that are not available to you when you're not getting laid. So that's good and bad. Now with that knowledge, you know, you can use that to just say, hey, I'm gonna get laid no matter what the cost. Like, I need to go out and do this. And then once you start to get laid more and more, then when you go out, it's a lot, you're just a little bit smoother. You're just a little bit less grabby. You're just a little bit more relaxed around women, and they sense it on you. So, you know, having sex is a big part of this whole non-needy thing. If you're not having sex yet, don't worry about it. It's coming. Just go out enough. And if you have to use online dating to get it, you know, get it through online dating as well. And as soon as you break through and you start to get laid regularly with hot chicks, then there's going to be some little level of communication you have that the girl's going to be able to pick up and be like, oh wow, this guy is really like not needy. He's not freaking out about me being here.
I feel like I could sleep with this guy. And the script will flip, where all of a sudden, you know, you were normally the one doing the chasing. Now she is the one that's doing the chasing. You know, they'll be like, do you have condoms? You know, like, oh,
you know, she'll start saying all the sex stuff, you know, to see where you're at with sex. And it's like, you know, you're the one that's just not really, you know, you're not really phased by it. You're going to go for it if you want to go for it, but you're not really so phased by, you know, the prospect of having sex versus a guy who hasn't had in a while. And this happens to any guy, by the way, guy hasn't had in a while. He's like twitchy. He's like, what'd you say? Like, he's like, oh my God, what's going on here? And it's just, it creeps the girls out. And it's nothing you can control. So the main takeaway of this is get yourself some girls that you're sleeping with as soon as possible. And it just
lightens the load.
It just lightens the load. And by the way, to girls who think this is fucking creepy, you're all getting laid, okay? You're all getting laid. You could get laid whenever you want. So you don't understand the plight of most men who can't get laid. You have no idea what it's like. So that's why when women try to insert their little opinion about this stuff, I'm just like, you have no fucking idea what that's actually like. Even the ugliest woman in the world can still get laid. I mean, maybe not the ugliest, but, you know, it goes pretty low. So, you know, it's just a different struggle. So just shut up. You know, if you don't understand it, just shut up and keep your opinion to yourself, because you just don't understand what it's like for a guy who has to go out and put in all this work to get it. You just go outside, you get some guy to take care of you, so stop. Now,
with that said, you know, arm yourself with this knowledge.
Remember, you know, the first sale,
the first lay,
the first relationship or whatever, that's always a groundbreaking moment. So get yourself there as soon as possible, and the abundance will start to flow in an upward spiral as long as you keep going out.